वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, आई एम राजदीप आचार्य बैक अगेन विथ अनदर न्यू ट्यूटोरियल वीडियो। एंड इन दिस वीडियो विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टीनोफोरा एंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ टीनोफोरा। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सो बेसिकली टीनोफोरा इज ए फाइलम नेम व्हिच केम फ्रॉम टू ग्रीक वर्ड। वन ग्रीक वर्ड इज एक्चुअली के टी ई एन ओ एस ओ टीनोस व्हिच एक्चुअली स्टैंड फॉर comb, and another Greek word is actually phoros which is stand for to bear. So basically Tinophora is a phylum name which came from two Greek word. One is actually tinos and the other one is actually phoros, and if we attach these two words, we will get comb to bear. That means those animals which bear comb plate in their body organism, those animals are actually belongs to Tinophora phylum. So now we will be talking about the definition of Tinophora. So what are the characteristic features through which we can define a phylum that this phylum belongs to Tinophora? So basically the first point which actually a phylum should be a c o e l o m a t e. So basically a phylum should be acoelomate. That means this phylum should not have coelom in their organism. The second thing is a phylum should be diploblastic. Third thing is a phylum should have coloblast cell which is actually adhesive cell present in the tentacle. And the fourth thing is a phylum should have lithocyst which act as sense organ. And the fifth thing is the phylum should have at least comb plate, which is actually the main point, the main characteristic feature of Tinophora. A phylum should have comb plate, and a phylum should be developed from cydipate larva. So basically a phylum which include acoelomate, diploblastic and coloblast cell, lithocyst, complete and developed from cydipate larva defined as Tinophora. So basically it is the definition of Tinophora. Now we will be talking about the characteristic features of Tinophora, which are the main characteristic features through which we can define a phylum which is actually Tinophora. So basically from this definition we can say that a phylum which does not have coelom, a phylum which is actually diploblastic, a phylum having coloblast cell, a phylum having lithocyst, a phylum having complete, a phylum developed from cydipate larva. These are the characteristic features. So basically first characteristic is body. So basically our first characteristic is body. The body of this Tinophora either transparent or it can be fat or it can be cylindrical. So it is the first characteristic features of phylum Tinophora. Now we will move to the next characteristic features of Tinophora. The next characteristic features is locomotory organ. So basically the locomotory organ is comb plate, which is actually the main characteristic features of Tinophora. Comb plate. Now we will move to the third characteristic features, which is actually the sense organ. The sense organ is the lithocyst which help this phylum, the animals of this phylum to sense the external environment. So basically it will be lithocyst. The fourth characteristic feature is larva. So basically we have talking before that the animal of this phylum developed from cydipate larva. So basically the larval form is actually cydipate, and also the fifth point of view is actually phylum. So basically these animals are not having phylum. So basically phylum absent. In this case phylum is absent. Now we will be talking about the sex. So basically the sex is united. So basically these are the characteristic features of phylum Tenopura. You also guys can write that it is actually diploblastic and it is having coloblast cell. So we also can say that these phylums are having the seventh characteristic feature is actually this phylum is having coloblast cell in their tentacles which act as a adhesive cell. So now we'll move to the character, the classification. So basically according to Rupert and Barnes, 6th edition 1994, this phylum Tenopura actually this phylum Tenopura Tenopura, this is actually the phylum Tenopura divided into two class. One class is actually Tentaculata, another class is actually Nuda. So these are the two classes of this phylum Tenopura, and this classification is followed by Rupert and Barnes, 6th edition 1994. So now we'll be talking about the class of Tentaculata and Nuda. So now we'll be talking about the class Tentaculata. Tentaculata. So basically Tentaculata, and the characteristic feature of Tentaculata is, the first thing is Tentaculata are having two tentacles are present. Mouth aperture, now we'll be talking about the mouth aperture. Mouth aperture, which is actually wide. And now we'll be talking about the meridional canal, which is actually unbranched. And example of Tentaculata, now we'll be talking about that example is velamen, velamensp. And now we'll be talking about the class of Nuda, nuda, Nuda. So basically the first thing is no tentacle स्केल, सेकेंड थिंग इज माउथ एपर्चर व्हिच इज एक्चुअली स्मॉल, थर्ड थिंग इज एक्चुअली मेरिडियनल कैनल, मेरिडियनल कैनल व्हिच इज एक्चुअली ब्रांच. सो दीज आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ नूडा. नाउ वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ नूडा. द एग्जाम्पल इज एक्चुअली बेरो एसपी, BERO ESPी. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ फाइलम टीनोफोरा, इनवर्टिब्रेट फाइलम टीनोफोरा. एंड आई होप यू गाइस हैव अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ टीनोफोरा. आई होप इट विल हेल्प यू इन योर स्टडी. सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड. And subscribe this channel and also like this video and share this video among your friends who are in need of this topic. Thank you so much, guys.